ஆபதாம் அபஹர்த்தாரம் தாதாரம் சர்வசம்பதா லோகாபிராமம் ஸ்ரீராமம் பூயோ பூயோ நமாம்யஹம். ஜெய் ஸ்ரீமன்நாராயண். டியர் பகவத் பந்துஸ், வி ஆர் சோ ப்ரிவிலேஜ்ட் டு பி ஹியர் வித் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ ஆன் திஸ் வண்டர்ஃபுல் குளோபல் ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் மஹோத்சவ், விச் இஸ் aiming from inner peace to world peace. It's a great Eupatorian ideology, isn't it? But is it really practical? Yes, it is practical when the governance is great, when the laws are perfect, when the administration is strict. It's really practical. But now, are we seeing that in the reality? We know the Lord Rama reached his own place again recently in Ayodhya. And now, Ramarajya is expected. We want Ramarajya, where every citizen is respected. And every part of this nature is also respected. Rama appeared on this earth during Treta Yuga, two yugas before, probably it is said, 1.75 million years ago. It is said Rama wanted to, or probably his avatar is to make a model human being or show that to the society as how an ideal society should be. We can go on talking about the great qualities that one has to possess, taking the example of Rama. As long as Rama was in his kingdom, he saw one type of world and he was pretty happy with it. But after some time, Rama entered the real world, to the forest. He spent there for a few years. And then he found the real world. There, people are not happy. People are enveloped with a kind of terrorism in animal kingdom, in demon kingdom, and thus in human kingdom too. And he thought, it's not something that I need to practice to set these things to right. They should be dealt with properly. And for that, he dealt with Wali, who was an animal in the forest, in an appropriate manner. And he dealt with Ravana in another way to control him. Then he returned and then started inculcating that peace among the human beings, what was called as Ramraj. As long as there was Wali, as long as there was Ravana-like beings, Rama was not able to spread the message of peace, because to practice something from within, you need, first of all, the body should cooperate. And the body should be secured, protected. But that was lacking because of persons like Walis and Ravanas. Until and otherwise, that terrorism was strongly taken care and perfect system was established to take care of the rest of the people. He was not able to establish the peaceful life, what we call inner peace. Then Valmiki said, the great sage who recorded that historic time, Ramo, Ramo, Rama iti prajanam abhavan katha. Rama bhutam jagadabhut, Rame rajyam prasasati. When Rama was ruling the kingdom by practicing all good qualities that he was possessing, and he was inculcating among the human beings, because there were no terrorist external forces on those people, they were able to practice those things, for which we need to first of all have an understanding as how to respect each individual. Rama has given a great chance to even Ravana to rectify himself, not to become a terrorist and be cohesive with the rest of the world. But Ravana was not able to listen to that, and thus made him, Rama, to control Ravana. We need to understand something here. After eliminating Wali, Rama was not interested in establishing his own kingdom there. It was again those people have to rule their own kingdom, and Rama allowed Sugriva to be the ruler, again an animal king, to take care of those animals. And when Ravana was eliminated, Rama was not interested in establishing his own kingdom there. He was not interested in converting those people. He wanted them to practice their own culture, their own civilization, and their own traditions and customs. He never looked down towards them And he never wanted to impose his own things on them. He made again another demon called Vibhishana, who wanted to understand the systems, and then allowed them to rule their own people. We know today, people across the world are under the clutches of terrorism. If it is just at the sprouting level of the terrorism, yeah, it can be addressed with, definitely with inner peace. But when it started spreading its branches and roots so wide and strong, then the need is the rulership, and then perfect and stringent laws and the bureaucratic system to follow that very strictly. Then only people of that land will be able to practice whatever you say. Otherwise, when there are pressures, when there is violence, how anybody will be able to practice it? People need a kind of a security for their food, clothes, shelter. If the rulers of that land are able to provide these things to the people first, and then there won't be any kind of a need for the people just to turn back from their faiths just for the sake of food or shelter or health, or they need not become victims for any kind of allurement. Bharat was a place for good culture, good civilization, and having open hands for anybody from across the world. Because Bharat believed that we need to worship whatever we believed in. At the same time, we need to respect the systems of the world, whatever they are. And thus, we have to live with each other. I need to respect you. I need to follow my own worshiping, my own way taught by my predecessors, my gurus, and my forefathers. But sometime what happened? The people from across the world believed in worshipping their own, but forgot respecting others. People in Bharat also remembered that we need to respect everybody, but worshipping our own was forgotten. Thus, this country was under the rulership or invasion of others for thousands of years. Fortunate enough, we are in Amrita Kal today, because the people who are at the rulership now to this country are able to understand that we need to provide all sorts of security to our people for food, for cloth, for shelter, and for their own self-empowerment. Probably recently we heard that under Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana, our beloved Prime Minister assured people that you get minimum 5 kgs of your foodstuff for another 5 more years. Started probably during the period of COVID. assurance for their living, so that they need not be allured by others, need not be turned back from their faith and adopt something else of others. Rulership is great, strong, stringent with the laws. Then the people will feel security to turn to inside and then start excavating the peace. My friends, there are systems which are working well across the world. If you look at Australia, where they strongly stick on to the law of the land and they never compromise with the law of the land, and they never disrespect the systems of others, whoever living in their country. But if somebody wants to say, because we are major in number, we want to follow our own law, then the Australian government will very gently say, it is really great to follow, to believe, to stick on to your own practices, which sometimes may not be in coherence with the law of this land. But then you can go to a place other than this country where you can practice them safely, please. My friends, why I mentioned this to you? As long as the ruling of the country is not strong enough to protect their own law of the land and a common code for everybody, you won't expect peace there. Terrorism will definitely take place, because the creator of these human beings, we hear the names in different ways, let the name be anything. The creator of these human beings created with two faults. It is probably the mistake that he made. One, domination, and second, possessiveness. These two are manufactured defects of human beings. He made the man like this. I need to possess whoever comes on my way. I want to dominate them. Probably the reason of science, the reason of technology, the reason of any advancement is to prove one to be more dominating and more possessive. But when the rulers of the land are able to understand the value of following one's own law of the land and respecting every others from across the world, then there won't be any kind of problem. Fortunate enough, we are calling this time as Amrita Kal. You know why? After 75 long years of independence, we have the government at the center who understand the law of this land, the culture of this land, and the civilization of the human race on this earth. We know very well though there are departments from the center, and never they have taken an initiative to have a department of culture and to do something for that. But now it is probably became Amritakal, because they wanted to see that the culture is preserved. And the inner core of the culture must be brought out by bringing all people together and talk about how we can be together. There will be definitely some kind of differences, because difference is something make everything unique. My this finger is different than this finger. There is a difference, but there is no disturbance. There is difference, but there is no clash. We want these two fingers must be together to work with each other, respecting the system of each finger. Then only your hand will be able to produce something good. Same with religions, same with spiritual paths. As just now we heard from our respected speakers, spirituality has so many facets. As Gopalji rightly said, 1 + 9 = 10, 8 + 2 = 10, 7 + 3 = 10. There are so many ways. We need to respect each way. So there are wonderful religions across the world which are able to bring people together. Spirituality and the religion are two very, very powerful things which are able to bring people together and control the minds of people. If they understand the value of worshipping one's own and respecting the rest, let it be anything. I may be a believer in some power called God, and my friend may be a non-believer of God. Doesn't matter. That belief and the faith are only for one's own growth, not to fight with the other. And if I want to grow by myself with my faith to understand others, it's really great. Let your atheism be with you in your growth. Let my faith in God be with me in growing by myself. But let both of us be together. Why? Because we want to live in a society. We want to be with the society. And we want to go with the society. And thus, we both, an atheist and an atheist, should go together, work together for the benefit of the society ultimately. I need not convert you as a devotee. You need not convert me as an atheist also. Because our faiths are divine. Our faiths are serene. So let us stick on to our faiths. Let us stick on to our beliefs. And let us worship them. At the same time, let us respect the rest of the systems of the world. This is what exactly Rama did during his time. He believed in the animals' system, and hence he did not want them to convert as humans. No. You live as you are, but be with the society. Don't harm others. So made Sugriva the ruler there. And then he believed in demons also, because they are also a few creatures and they have to survive in their own way. So he made not them as humans, but again he made another demon ruler, Vibhishana, who is able to understand, work with the society as the ruler of them. And he led a friendly life with them. Rama was friendly to Sugriva animals. Rama was friendly to demons. Rama was friendly to the sages and others. We as humans should have such a kind of government and the rulers who are able to protect our own faiths and cultures, at the same time able to provide a security for all of us, so that one need not capture, occupy, dominate others and then want to grow oneself. If that system is adopted, it will be really great. We offer our prayers to our current rulers of our center, who are able to think about the culture of this land, the core of this Bharat Atma, that is, practicing one's own with worshipping nature and respecting everything. As a matter of fact, that is the very reason why atheists came to this land, Islamic people came to this land, Christians came to this land, Zoroastrians came to this land. Many, many religions, many faiths, many people from across the world came and able to settle down in this land. That is the greatness of our Bharat. Accepts everything. But at the same time, worships her own law of the land and common code for everyone equally. This is what Ramana just said 1,000 years before. 1,000 years before. And practiced it to the word and spirit of that. And fortunately today, we have our beloved Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, who believed in this and want to see that it is practiced to the spirit and letter of that. Worship your own and respect all. But remember, when such a time comes for us to practice really, but till then, that is not the end. That security is only for the physical body. But the real purpose of the life is something different. That is a higher purpose. That is inner peace. Inner peace is the ultimate. So, I say, from inner peace to world peace, or from world peace to inner peace? Is the egg first or the hen first? If the debate comes, here are great scholars, great leaders, great gurus, great thinkers and visionaries who are able to guide us. And here in our Kanha Shanti Vanam, our Daji is providing a very beautiful and very auspicious platform for people to discover by themselves. But let us all pray to the Almighty, whom people call as God with different names, to provide a perfect government, rulers, who will be able to follow the Atma of this Bharat and at the same time make the law common for everybody and make the bureaucratic system also to work perfectly to their ideology and let the Ministry of Culture take their core ideology to different organizations, those who are assembling here from across the world, to come out with their common ideology where all of us can work together. All of us to work for the society at the same time, following our own customs, practices, and traditions. Our Mangalasasanams to Daji for his good health and long age, so that he can be a sutram for all the manis to glow well and glorify the humankind for the future peace and future prosperity. We are very happy that all of you are here to take that joy of understanding the inner peace, and thus can multiply it manifold to spread it to your friends and relatives across the globe. God bless you all, and Jai Sriman Narayan.